G'day, Andrew Murray here from Apartment Specialists, talking about body corporate minutes or AGM minutes and what to look for if you're a purchaser or a vendor or an owner in your minutes when you see them each year and what things you may want to look into further to make sure you're making either the right decision if you're a purchaser or if an owner, be aware of everything that's going on. Okay, so here we can see the properties at 71, 73 Lawn Street. This is the Regency Apartments. And then the general meeting here. And so firstly, you have who's present. Then you have election of the chairperson. It's something that's quite important. Here you can see I am the chairperson of the Regency Apartments. Now, when you see something in the body corporate minutes, when it says moved, here Derek Payne seconded, Christian Larson. What that means is you're in the AGM, imagine all these people, and someone goes, yes, I passed that motion, the other person, it needs another person to go, yes, I agree, and everybody on the floor to go, okay, then the motion is passed. Okay, so what I've done is I've highlighted areas where of note, which you should be aware of and of importance and maybe that require as a purchaser to look into or an owner to maybe question. Okay, so you have apologies and proxies. So a proxy is where somebody can't be at the meeting, at the AGM, so an owner can't, and they give their right or their vote to another owner. So in this case, you had the building manager held a proxy for Peter Tindall of Unit 2D, and the apologies for Patricia of Unit 2E for not being there from the complex. Now there are 49 apartments in the apartment of the Regency, so that's pretty good. And what you want to look here is if there's a particular individual that's holding a lot of proxies, that may or may not be a good thing, and you may want to look into that because that means they have influence at meetings. Anyway, so then you have body corporate committee, okay, then gets elected. As you can see, you've got 8 members here, including obviously myself being chairman. Then goes through minutes of the previous annual general meeting, as you can see here. Okay, they were moved and approved. Then the accounts, and this is an important part, so this is when you want to see the accounts. Here to find which your accounts were gone through, and at the AGM, you go through them individually, line by line, everything that's spent, you know, income and expenditure, and making sure that's all in order, and that was passed and seconded, and that was all in order. Okay, then you've got evaluation and insurance. Now, this is always talked about. Why? Because it's generally the biggest ticket item, the most expensive part of the budget. So this is when you're talking about the valuation of the building, what are the terms of it, of insurance, which is a lot, say, like car insurance. You can either have a higher value, which means you have to pay a higher excess, and you know, that kind of thing. Okay, and it goes into the specifics of what the insurance covers, which is generally, for example, if there was flooding in your unit, what would the insurance be? What would the insurance company pay out in regards of rent? You know, if there's an earthquake, what would happen, etc. Then you have common maintenance matters. Now, this is very important. Okay, this is probably the most important part of the minutes. This is when you're seeing what issues are happening or if there are any issues and that kind of thing. Here you can see, oh, lift. First thing, lift is an expensive thing. So as soon as you see lift, think, oh, okay, I need to look into this. It was noted here that the committee may wish to look at another brand of lift. The committee has previously agreed to engage Lyle Senior, who's a lift expert, to evaluate lift options. It was agreed to put aside $50,000 each year for the next 2 years for the lift refurbishment replacement. Okay, so that's been done in the long-term maintenance plan, but it's been moved forward a little bit. So you want to look at that. You want to look at the contingency fund, or what it used to be called the sinking fund, and see that there's money in place. And it's going to be raised by 2016. In this case, it is. But you definitely want to look into that. As soon as you see that, as a purchaser, you want more information. So ask the agent to get through the body corporate or the owner more information on that matter, or your lawyer to look through it. Now, you then see, okay, oh, an external repaint should be done around 2018, 2019. Well, that's a good thing because it's going to raise values to the building. So it's showing that the committee or the body corporate focusing on how to raise values, which means they must have enough money going on, otherwise they'd be addressing it on issues. Okay, because the external paint quality was seen as satisfactory, but the issue was the colour. Now that's purely aesthetic things, so it's purely about raising the values. That's a very good sign on a body corporate. As you can see here is the budget, and then have the budget moving forward for the next 12 months. And here you can see the largest ticket items being the building manager's fee, the insurance, as I mentioned earlier, and in the long-term maintenance fund, which is good because nearly one of the most expensive parts is actually money being put away for the long-term maintenance plan to enhance and to maintain the building. So that's a very good sign. And so when you see that those kind of figures, you'll be looking at the body corporate levy and seeing that's quite safe, and looking at the long-term maintenance plan, and this one is obviously the lift and a whole painting of the building about to be done. So once that's done, it looks like you're going to have a lot more money in the kitty, and maybe the levies will reduce, which would be a very good sign, or put to other areas to enhance values. Okay, so then as you go through, there's not too much of note here. It's just talking about levies being paid. If they're not paid, what is the body corporate doing? All that kind of thing. Our general business, long-term maintenance plan. As soon as you see that, okay, that's always very important. And it talks about the long-term maintenance plan as prepared by Opus, was tabled at the meeting. Okay, so as soon as you see that, oh, where is the long-term maintenance plan? Okay, so you want to ask the agent to go through the body corporate to get that long-term maintenance plan so you can have a look at it. Okay, then you see through here, not too much of note, utility interest, ownership interest. So then there's the body corporate operation rules. Okay, there's been a change. So what was that change? Now, in this case, it's talking about the ability to remedy availability to the body corporate. The body corporate shall be entitled to recover from a defaulting owner any fees, costs, expenditure, blah, blah, blah. So that's basically giving the body corporate the power to seek damage and just and go straight to basically a debt agency to raise funds if there was anything damage caused by another owner. And that was due to an owner that was overseas that hadn't, there was a leak from the shower and they didn't replace it in time and kept on not attending to the matter. It was tenanted and it damaged them alone, and we should be able to go after them for the costs, which we have. Okay, and I'll just put that in to make me feel good. And Kristen Larson, thank Andrew Murray for a great work as chairman. But anyway, has no relevance to what we're talking about at the moment. Anyway, okay, so here going through, this is all about more issues being brought up. This is the building manager's report here. So he's talking about this is when I gave a report, sorry. So this is talking about the roof of the lift pit looks corroded, may need repainting or replacing. So this is the very top of where the lift is. I noticed there's a little space there which was slightly corroded. Now that either needs to be painted or replaced. So what was done, it was just a little seal that's put on top of it. It wasn't a biggie. But if I was a purchaser and owner, I'd want to look into that a bit further, because we knew if that was a bigger problem than it sounded like. Now then also down here, I've got another matter that was brought up. There was an issue with the sound of banging pipes between unit I and H. Now plumbing is very expensive, so you might want to look into that. At the end of the day, it was an old building, so it was what was called water hammer. Now I'd never heard of this before, and that's when your pipes bang because of the pressure, and that was all sorted out, so it wasn't a biggie. But as a purchaser and owner, you may want to look into that further. Then you can see what was at the end of the meeting. It was obviously closed at 7:30 p.m. and the points to be action was, you know, BCA to follow up with Lionel Senior, who's that lift expert, to obtain an evaluation of the lift. That goes to, you can see the money was being raised to do that by 2016, which is in line with the long-term maintenance plan, so that all fits. And the BCA to raise an extra $25,000 for two consecutive years. So this tells you, okay, the body corporate levy is probably going to increase slightly, and you're probably going to look at that and ask your real estate agent to get the information on the body corporate on what kind of increase that would be. It ended up being a couple of $100, but as a purchaser, you'd want to be aware of that. Anyway, that is a bit of a mouthful, but it gives you an example of when you're reading through these body corporate minutes, what to look out for, what's happening, and, you know, things come up, when to ask questions, when to look further. Not to just go, okay, I've read the minutes, I'm fine. But you need to address them and do all your investigations to make sure that body corporate of the complex you're looking at buying into is a healthy one. Anyway, I hope that helps. Cheers.